All right, in this little video, I'm going to talk about a particular strategy to develop strength in the clean and press. It's not to say that it's the only way to do it, it's just a way that I've been using recently that's worked quite well, so I thought it would be nice to just kind of flesh it out here. So recently I discovered that I had built up my one arm clean and press with a kettlebell to be able to press the 40 kilo that's behind me for a rep. Now, I have not, that's to say that that's a personal record. I haven't clean and pressed a 40 kilo kettlebell before. Now, there may have been other times in the past where I've had a similar sort of strength level with barbell pressing. But I've had a long layoff from that type of training, so it's definitely in the realm of a personal record for me. Now, I have a 40 kilo kettlebell, I have a 32, 24, and a 20. So up until the point recently where I pressed the 40, what I'm getting at here is there's a large gap between 32 and the 40. So I'd worked up to clean and press the 32 for a reasonable number of reps, let's say 4 or 5. And then, but that won't allow you to press the 40, at least for most it won't. So you need to do something to bridge that gap. Now, if you had more kettlebells, like if you had a 34, a 36, a 38, you could just keep doing clean and press. But if you don't, then you need to do something else. Now, I don't have a dip bar or anything else here, other that might be an option to do dips and work on other things with the kettlebell. The specific thing that I did was that I went up to the 40, but then instead of pressing it from standing or working on the standing pressing pattern, I did floor presses with the 40. There's a little bit of the specifics of getting into the position, which we can't get into here now. But I was able to take then start with the floor press with reps of two, like sets of two, then sets of three, sets of four. Now I'm working sets of five, but once I got to sets of four, the clean and press from standing just happened. Now in my other training, I do cleans themselves in combination with other exercises that keeps the clean just being there. So that's just to say that the floor press in itself may or may not be the right thing for you. So I know for me, stand like representing a kettlebell press, I know for me that I can get from here and up. That's fine. That's not where my weak point is. I know that getting to this point and then locking out is where my weakness is, which is also why if you look at the floor press, it only gets to about this elbow angle. But because I'm strengthening that range of motion, it obviously carried over to the standing clean and press. Now, if your weakness is down below, like it's here and not up here, you may not find the same thing. So it's just keep in mind that it's not a universal recipe. But it was with the kettlebells that I have, with the training that I've done up until this point, this particular way of doing things carried over and allowed me to make strength gains with this particular setup. So there is some, you have to think about things a little bit differently when there is this large gap between a 32 and a 40 if you want to move into pressing the 40. So the other things could be done is obviously push press or jerks with the 40, and eventually building up enough volume, and then that might give you a press. So there's certainly more than one option. I like the floor press because it's quite controlled and you can gradually build up more volume with it and then can work on other parts of the press in other movements. So yeah, that's how I've done it in this particular instance. I'll probably do something else. I'm working up towards doing it with a 48 and then might have to do things a little bit differently. We'll see when that time comes. But the floor press and then still having a clean somewhere else in the training seems to work quite well. So need to have a base, need to be able to press first. And yeah, So there's other things, but that's a large part of the puzzle.